Hey everyone, Rodney here at Klebs Tech, and today I'll be talking about a powerful free AI-powered upscaling tool that you can run locally on your computer. We'll cover how to use it, explore its features, and add custom models. I'm talking about Upscale. Now, if we look at their website, they do plan on having a cloud service that is coming soon with a bunch of features, but today I'm going to be going over the downloaded version. They do offer versions for Linux, Mac, and Windows, and I'll be using the Windows version here in the video. They do offer an installable version or a portable one. I prefer the portable because I can just extract it to a folder, run everything in there, and I can move it around easily, but that's up to you which way you prefer to do it. Now, as for compatibility, they do mention needing a Vulkan-compatible GPU to upscale images. Most dedicated GPUs should work, and they do have some info on compatibility on GitHub if you run into any problems. Since I'm running Upscale portable version, I do have just the folder, so I've extracted that. If you have it installed, you can launch it how you would normally launch a program. But since I have it in the portable version, I've just extracted the folder. I'm just going to go ahead and launch the .exe file. Now, once you launch it, this is the interface that you're going to have. And right away, you notice in the top left here, we have the batch option. So you can actually go into a batch mode, select the folder, upscale a bunch of images if you want to. You do want to make sure that that only contains supported file types. You could even use this to upscale a video if you converted the video to a bunch of each frame into an image, upscale it, and bring it back in. I'm not going to cover how to do that, but that is something I might experiment with myself at some point. I will mention, if you're going to be putting different types of images and doing batch, you probably, if you have digital art or photos, you want to separate those because the results you're going to get from different models to upscale is going to be different depending upon the art style that you're working with. So in here, I'm going to go back, turn off batch for this purpose. I'm going to select my image. Now you can either click on that and find the image, or you can actually just drag your image in. So here we have a regular image. I'm going to use a photo to start off with. This is an actual photo that I took. It's a lower resolution one. And now in here, since it's a photograph type, I'm going to change that, the model, to a general photo. You can try different versions to see the results that you get. If you're doing digital art, you'd want to do a digital art for that. You're going to get different results depending on that image type. A double upscale, if you want to really upscale it, you can click that off. You're going to get a 16x upscale on your image. Do keep in mind, if it's a very large image resolution or anything like that, you may run into some issues, and it can take a while. You'd want to, if you want to change your output folder and have it go to a specific output folder, you can do that here. Otherwise, it's going to default to the same path of the file that you added to upscale, and it's going to put the output into that same folder. And then we have the upscale button, which down here, it tells us what we're going to be going from and then the resolution we're going to end up with. So let's go ahead and hit upscale. Now for upscales that aren't super large, it actually runs pretty quickly, I find. Okay, we have our image upscaled. And now when we go over, you have multiple options. And this part I do find a little bit bugged out. So if we go over here to the right, you're going to have a tab where you can choose the zoom or lens size. So let's go actually with the slider view first. So this view, now I got to turn off that zoom amount. There we go. Close that. Okay. Now our slider, we can use that to see the difference between the original and the upscaled one. And really don't see an awful lot here. It's hard to notice the differences when you do this. So this is the original, this is the upscaled. So the other option we have is you can go to lens view. We can crank that way up if we want. And let's see, here we go. Now, when we go into this view, we can actually see around the circle is what the original one looked like. And then the upscaled is inside that circle. So you can see the detail that was added. Some things I think it does better on, like in this image, I don't think it did the bubbles quite as well. And that's where sometimes you can experiment with the different models to see the results that you get out of those models. So when it comes to the digital art, so I went ahead and I've already upscaled this previously. So I took this image here. This is an original image I created in Midjourney. I didn't upscale it or anything like that in Midjourney. Just to give you an idea of the results you'll get using photo versus the digital art model. Upscaled it several times with different ones. So on the left here, this is the original one. And then in the middle, we have the photo model that I used, which picked up more of the details of the face. And then on the right is the digital art one. And as you can see, it smoothed out a lot of stuff. It got rid of all the smaller details, which is something you may be going for, but that is something to be aware of how these models handle things differently and different art styles. You may wanna use different models to get the results that you're looking for. Okay, so as far as the settings go in Upscale, our first options obvious at the top is if you need help, you can click on this. It'll bring you to the Upscale wiki on GitHub and you can find some information on there. There's not an awful lot, but then again, there's not an awful lot to the program either. So, but you will find the discussions and everything in there. If you'd like to donate, you can do that as well. You do have your logs here and you can click on the copy logs for troubleshooting if you need to copy and paste them into somewhere. Then you have the Upscale theme. If you want different look, you can change these. I prefer just the default. You can also change what the resulting image type is. Don't post-process the image. So if you click this off, it won't do any of the post-processing. It'll just upscale and that's it. I don't see really much difference between the two. I haven't run into any problems, so I haven't used that option. Next up, you have the image scale slider. The default is 4x, but if you wanted to go down, you could change that as well. If you want to do a custom width, you can put that in here. Check that, and that'll override the settings above here for the actual scaling of the image. You can also use image compression if you'd like, which seems to be experimental. I haven't used that myself. If you want to have it saved to a specific output folder and remember it, you can check this off and it will remember it between sessions. Now the override previous upscale, if you enable this, my understanding, and I don't use this, is once you upscale it, an image and you go back into here, it'll reuse the same image that you've already upscaled into the next upscale. You can turn off notifications, so if you don't want to get annoying chimes when it's done. Now, as far as the GPU ID goes, if you want to, and a lot of times this is only if you have any issues. If you don't have any issues, then you probably don't need to worry about it. But if you want to put your GPU ID in here, I know mine's 0, because if I go up to the log in here when I generated an image before, and I look through the log, I will actually see right here the number 0, NVIDIA GeForce 3070. So that way I know that's the number for the GPU that I'm using. You could put a different one if you have multiples in there, stuff like that. The other thing you want to mention is that you want to enable performance mode on Windows for better results. I didn't find a big difference when I did that on Windows. All you need to do, if you go into your display settings, Windows 11 will be slightly different. But this is on Windows 10. And then I go down here to the graphics settings. And in here, under graphics performance preference, I've already got it set for that. But let's say I didn't. All I would do is click on browse. I go to the folder where I have my upscale saved. I'm gonna choose the .exe file. Now, if you have it installed, you'd have to go to your install folder and find the .exe file in there. And then we are all set and go into options and we can choose high performance and save. Now, I believe I have my system set to high performance anyways, so I don't think that's why I didn't see much of a difference when I was running things. When you're doing basic upscales, you probably won't notice much of a difference and it's probably that important. But when you start doing like the larger 16x upscales, that might be beneficial at that point. If you want to add custom models, you can do it here. If we go to the wiki guide for upscale, and then you go into your custom models over here, and I'll include a link in the description of the video for this. But if we go to the wiki under the custom models, you'll find they actually do have some in here, and they explain how to convert models if you want to. So in here, I go to custom models repository they have listed, which will bring us to here. And I'm gonna go ahead and download this repository and I'm gonna save it. So this is my upscale folder here. I'm gonna go ahead and save my zip file in there that I just downloaded. Okay, so we have it downloaded here. So I'm gonna just go ahead and extract all, extract it into here. I can go ahead and delete that. So now I have a new folder in here. So all I need to do now, once I have the folder where I want it, I'll go into here, select the folder, and we have ours in here. There we go. And we now have our custom models added. And the last option in here is reset upscale. That will reset all your settings back to default. So now with the, when it comes to the custom models, if we go back to our main menu, you're gonna now notice we have more models in here. I'm not gonna go in to all the different, what each one of these does. They do have on their website down here, it kind of explains what each one is good for, what they do. And that pretty much covers the settings of upscale. You're gonna have to do a lot of trial and error with any of these things. I do find I use Focus for generating AI images. And I do find I found the upscaling in there works better for the initial 2x upscale. And then I'll bring it into here to upscale it further. Now for this example, this one I generated in Focus. It's the default size. I haven't upscaled it in Focus or anything like that. So for this one, I just want to show the comparison of using, I think this will give you a good idea of the digital art versus the photo. So for the photo, I'm going to go ahead and upscale that. And we'll look at that. And then I'm gonna show you what the digital results will look like for the same image. Once we've done it with the photo version, you can see it maintains its look of a photo and it adds a lot more detail. But if we go over and we change this to digital art and I upscale it that way, you're gonna see that the hair and stuff like that is not gonna be as fine detail. You get a lot more smooth effects. That's what you're gonna find between the digital art and the photo results. On the right would be the digital art one, on the left is the photo one. And you can see that the digital art one is smooth things out a little more. The photo one adds a little more detail for the hair. And then you have a lot of other ones if you add. I find some of these additional models do a pretty good job depending on the image. So this is the original photo of the tree that fell down outside my house during the snowstorm, or actually just the branch. So I took that photo, upscaled it, and on the left is the original photo, and on the right is the upscaled photo using the photo, general photo, the default option in upscale. And if we go in even further, you can see a lot more of the detail was added. And I find overall it does a pretty good job. I occasionally will get images I'm not happy with, but I find that's the case with a lot of things. I do compare it to some of the other ones. One of my favorite online upscalers is Magnific AI. That does a phenomenal job, but it's also very expensive. That's the downfall of that one. Now for this image here, the one on the left is the original. And then I use the photo one in the middle. And then on the right is the digital art one. Give you an idea of how each one handles things differently. So for this one as a digital art image, I would much rather have the one on the right. I think it does much better. And then I took an old photo I had here, and on the left is the original, and on the right is the upscaled version. And we zoom in, we can actually see it did a really good job on overall, the detail that it added. But it's not always going to make every image look perfect. Some images just won't go well. So this is one I have that's a pretty low quality and older image. And if we go in here and we do the upscale on the general photo upscale, this one is a perfect example of one that really isn't gonna get much better. I mean, it does add some details, but the problem is it doesn't have a lot of details to begin with. So the resulting image just, I don't think is gonna be that much. I mean, it's a little better, but that's probably the most I would upscale it. Upscaling it even more than that, it just smooths everything out. So you're not gonna work miracles necessarily. With images. This is another one I did, and I can't demonstrate it any other way easily because this limit image is so large. This one on the right is almost 600 gigabytes in size, 32,000 pixels by 18,000. Haha. If we zoom in, we can see how much a difference that actually makes. Now the original image was already upscaled. I had done that in Magnific. And then I upscaled it again with upscale. So unless you can or want to pay for an online upscaler like Magnific AI, which I think is probably the best upscaler at the moment. I recommend Upscale as my go-to upscaler. If you found this video helpful, please consider hitting the like button or even buying me a cup of coffee, which really does make a difference. Thanks for watching and have fun creating.